Father, in the name of Jesus,
amen.
We thank you because of the season of the showers of wonders. Lord, I pray tonight the rain of miracles, showers of blessing, showers of wonders, showers of healing, showers of deliverance, showers of manifestation from on high. Bring upon everyone in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Lord, let all the dry season of wilderness stop in every life. Manifest yourself in a wonderful way in every life tonight. Wonders, miracles, signs, the supernatural to flow into every life tonight in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Fill every pail, every bucket, every drum, every home, every heart, every house with showers tonight in Jesus' name. We know it is done. We give you the glory. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
There's an amen from heaven upon your soul.
All the amen.
We're looking at Ezekiel chapter 34. And tonight, I'm talking to you on the season of showers of wonders. And everyone there, the rain of miracles will be falling tonight upon you. When there are showers, when the rain is falling, if you want your dryness to go, if you want your empty bucket to be full, if you want your ground not to be dusty anymore but to be refreshed, you don't stay in one corner there crying, oh God, I want all this darkness to go. Don't cry. Come out to the rain, that rain will come upon you. When the rain is falling and you want that rain upon your home, you don't stay in one corner somewhere mourning, sorrowful, telling stories. Oh God, for 5 years now I've been in dry season, and for this time now I've been in dry season, I'm sweating. Don't tell stories. The rain is falling. Come out. Dryness will vanish away in your life.
A
rain tonight. Wonders tonight. Healings tonight. Miracles tonight. The power of the Almighty God bringing supernatural manifestation on your life tonight in Jesus' name.
Ezekiel chapter 34 verse 26,
and I will make them at the places round about my heel a blessing. And I will cause the shower to come down in his season, and there shall be showers of blessing. It's our season. It is your season. Showers of blessing. Showers of the manifestation of the power of God. Showers of the glory of God. Showers of the supernatural coming from on high. The Almighty God says, I will make them and the places round about them a blessing.
Chineke bi n'eluigwe sịrị, m ga-emekwa ka ebe niile nke dị ugwu nta m gburugburu ghọọ ngọzi.
When God says yes, nobody can say no.
Mgbe Chineke na-asị ee, ọ dịghị onye ga-asị mba.
When God says I will, nobody can stand in his way.
Mgbe Chineke sịrị aga m eme ya, ọ dịghị onye ga-eguzo n'ụzọ ya.
A bulldozer is coming. And a man riding bicycle is sitting on the bicycle and is saying, bulldozer, you are coming, I'm staying here, get out of the way. That's it. As it crushes mountain, it can crush your bicycle.
The
bulldozer is coming. Mountains will be leveled. All those rocks in your life tonight, this is the night bulldozer is coming. That winking spirit, that whining spirit, that kind of spirit that is sitting there riding on that bicycle and wanting to stop your life, I'm telling that whining spirit, that weak spirit, get out of the way. Bulldozer is coming tonight. Somebody join leaf and cockroach and something together and is saying, I will kill you. I tell that man, tonight is different. Something is happening in deeper life, Enugu. I said something is happening in Enugu deeper life. A bulldozer is coming your way. Evil spirit, evil power, get out of the way.
I said deeper life, not just deeper life.
Give me a good amen. It is coming your way. I said, it is coming your way. All the seas, they'll be leveled tonight in Jesus' name. God says, I will. I will make them and the places round about my heel a blessing.
And
then he says, I, the God of heaven, the one who decides and determines, and nobody can reverse it. He said, I will cause the shower to come down in a season.
And
from tonight in your life, there shall be showers of blessing. Look at verse 30 there. Thus shall they know, you will know. Thus shall they know that I, the Lord their God, I am with them, and that they, even the house of Israel, are my people, says the Lord God.
And
ye, my flock, the flock of my people, amen, and I am your God, says the Lord.
Ma uno unu, igwewu naturu nkem, bi igwewu naturu nke ebitarim, maduka unu po, mu onwembu chineke unu, obu yesu no onye wa Jehovah pota.
Tonight is your night of wonders.
Abali abali nke ore bubegi.
We're going to do three things.
Aike mi hato.
One.
Nkembu.
You will enter.
Ega abanye.
Are you there?
in ebe a,
you will enter.
I ga abanye.
Two.
Nke abua,
you will experience.
I ga enwe nwaputa.
Once you enter,
ngwa ngwa ibanyere,
you will experience.
I ga enwe nwaputa.
Three.
Nke ato,
you will enjoy.
I ga borisi ndu.
For the rest of your life, you enjoy a life of wonders. The wonder of salvation, you enjoy. The wonder of sanctification and holiness, you enjoy. The wonder of deliverance, you enjoy. The wonder of healing, you enjoy. The wonder of deliverance and dominion, authority and power, you enjoy. You enter, you experience, you enjoy. You enter, you take that first step, you say, bye bye wilderness, bye bye dry season, now I enter.
Iga abanye iwe buruso we nwaputa si naabo osara naabo iponku dijite abatagomu.
As you enter, you begin to feel and experience the refreshing. Your soul becomes free. Your guilt is taken away. The joy of the kingdom comes in your heart. Your dim eyes is brightened. Your ears not hearing well, they begin to hear good sound. Your back that was bent to straighten up, the moment you enter, you experience, you straighten up. The moment you enter, the leg that was short grows out, is equal with the other one now. As you enter, you experience all your pile, everything is gone. You enter, you experience cancer vanishes away. As you enter and you experience, he makes you whole. You enter, you experience, and then every day now you enjoy your salvation. Every day now you enjoy your holiness and sanctification. Holiness is not sweating anymore, struggling anymore, you just enjoy holiness. Then you enjoy your healing. It will not come out of your mouth, I am sick, because you are well.
And
you are not weak anymore. Let the weak say, I am strong. And you are not poor anymore. The school fees of all your children, money will always be there. Coming from heaven, you will pay their school fees. Enemies, they fall. Enter, experience, enjoy.
Banye, wenwaputa,
oriendo. Tonight is my night.
Abali abu abalemo.
What are you?
Kebino.
Tonight is my night.
Abali abu abalemo.
Tonight, there's not going to be long preaching. Tonight is the night of wonders.
Abalia, ayaga ezi sozoma torogonogo. Abu abali nkorebube.
One,
Nkembo.
Two,
Nkabo.
Three,
Nkato.
It's over. I said one, two, three, and the rain will begin to fall. Number one, the promise of miracles and wonders. The promise that cannot fail. The promise that will not be delayed. The promise that will open the windows of heaven. The promise that will bring the showers down. The promise of miracles and wonders. Look at Luke chapter 4. In Luke chapter 4, I'm reading from verse 18. Luke chapter 4, verse 18. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Because he has anointed me to preach, to proclaim good news, the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted. To preach, to proclaim, to perform deliverance to the captives, and the recovering of sight to the blind, and to set at liberty them that are bruised. This is that night. The promise has gone out. The promise is now in your hand. And heaven is ready. The Spirit will not fail. The power of Jesus will not fail. And it is because he is anointed to preach good news, gospel, blessed information, blessed revelation, and that revelation declaration is coming to you tonight. It is yours. Gospel means good news. The good news you are hearing tonight will cancel every bad news from your life. Somebody says, you're a terrible sinner, you're going to hell. That's bad news. The good news tonight will cancel that bad news out of your life. I've been attending crusade for a long time. I've been trying for a long time and I've not been saved. Maybe I am not going to be saved. And then somebody said, you are the descendant of a demon, and demons don't get saved. That's why you have not been saved. Bad news. Good news is coming tonight, and the good news will cancel that bad news out of your life in Jesus' name.
I'm a hard worker.
I work, I run, I labor. I work like an elephant, I eat like an ant. I live from hand to mouth. And somebody told me have you not fasted? Have you not prayed? And that thing did not go. Just accept. It will be like that forever. Bad news. Good news is coming to you tonight. I said, good news coming to you tonight. All that bad news, the gospel, the good news will cancel it from your life in Jesus' name.
I always see
this woman in my dream. Pastor, can you believe? This woman has beard like a man. But she's a woman. And she told me, go anywhere you want. You didn't marry my daughter. Anywhere you go, anybody you marry, there will be no child. You will suffer in this life. Is that good news or bad news?
There's
good news coming to you tonight, and that good news will cancel every bad news out of your life in Jesus' name.
Jesus,
I come to tell you that tonight you're free. I come to tell you tonight that there's good news waiting for you. It will save you, it will heal you, it will deliver you, it will empower you. Showers will come upon your life in Jesus' name. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted. Your heart is broken. Your life is broken. Your body is broken. You cannot stand up. You're weak and anemic. It's like nothing is working in your system. Hospital is helping other people. Hospital does not help you. They say, take this. You've taken everything, but your life is still broken. There's healing for the brokenhearted tonight. Every damaged part of your body, of your life, will be repaired tonight. And then he says, and to preach deliverance to the captives. You know who they call captives? When people go to war, they catch those people of the enemy camp. They bring them back home. They put them in a cage, in a prison, in a confinement. They say that is a captive. And as they confine him there, he has a good brain. He cannot use his good brain. It's confined. He has good experience and good learning, good education. He cannot use anything. He's an imprisoned captive man. There's energy. He has muscle. But the man is a captive. They won't allow him to use anything that he has. He's in a cage. Every time he looks out, I wish I can be free. I have a lot of ideas. I wish I'm released into the free world. I will use all these good ideas. I came to open your prison doors tonight. That brain will be productive once again. That life will be successful once again. There's deliverance for the captives tonight. And the recovering of sight to the blind. Spiritual blindness will go away. Physical blindness will go away. And to set at liberty them that are bruised. What does that mean? Look at Joseph in Potiphar's prison.
Joseph,
a man that has a great dream, is in the prison. A man that had a great future is in the prison. A man that said, God told me this. That is where I'm going. Did it allow him to go there? The man's feet bruised in stocks right there because of the lie of Potiphar's wife. To set at liberty them that are bruised. The king is calling you. Come out. And then he came. And the king said, you are now ruler over the whole kingdom. He was set at liberty. You are set at liberty. To set at liberty them that are bruised. Look at Paul and Silas. Their feet stuck. Their hands changed. They bruised them. They beat them. But they knew showers will be coming. Showers of wonders coming. Showers of deliverance coming. To set at liberty them that are bruised. And Paul and Silas began to pray and began to sing.
Paul and Silas
and as they sang, the foundations of the prison shook. All the doors were open. Everything open. And all their chains, all the stores, everything totally loose. Paul was free. Silas was free. Somebody standing near Paul there was free. Another person near Silas there was free. All of them, everybody, they were free. Everybody, free. Where is everybody? Free. Are you free to search at liberty them that are bruised, and to preach the acceptable year of the Lord? And he closed the book and gave it to the minister and sat down, and the eyes of all the people were fasting in the synagogue, were fasting upon him. And he began to say unto them, this day is this scripture fulfilled in your ears. When is your season of showers? When is your day of showers? This promise is fulfilled in your ears. It will happen in your life in Jesus' name.
Number one,
the promise of miracles and wonders. Number two, the prayer with ministration of wonders. There are many kinds of prayer. Many types of prayer. For the prayer tonight,
it's
the one that comes with ministration of wonders. There's going to be a telephone line between here and there. As the ministration comes over here, manifestation will happen over there. I say, hello.
You see, hello.
Who is that? Okay, you are there. Ministration is coming now. Are you hearing me? Are you getting the manifestation now? Okay, praise the Lord. It is done. Can I hear the manifestation on the other side? You got it. It has happened. I said it has happened. There is a ministration coming from here. Your line will not be blocked. Your line will not be busy. As the ministration comes, manifestation will come right there in your life in Jesus' name. The prayer with ministration of wonders. Jeremiah chapter 33 verse 3.
Jeremiah 33 verse 3.
Call unto me and I will answer thee. Call unto me and I will answer thee and show thee great and mighty things which thou knowest not. A kind of healing you have never seen, you'll see tonight. A type of miracle you have never experienced, you'll experience tonight. Deliverance, wonder of deliverance coming upon you tonight in Jesus' name. Call unto me and I will answer thee. And it says, and I will show you great mighty things which you have not known. When you call upon the Lord, what do you say? We're looking at Jeremiah chapter 17 verse 14. Heal me, O Lord, and I shall be healed. Heal me, O Lord, and I shall be healed. Save me, and I shall be saved. Do you see, heal me, that is a prayer. I will be healed, that is the answer. There is no wall between heal me and I shall be healed. There is no gulf, impassable gulf, a ditch, a pit between heal me and I shall be healed. There is no personality between heal me and I shall be healed. The prayer goes forth immediately, the answer comes forth. And see, save me and I shall be saved. There is no wall of demarcation between save me, I shall be saved. There is no hindrance, there is no blockage, there is no, you know, stopping point between save me and I shall be saved. Once the prayer goes forth, the answer comes out. And tonight is that night. The prayer of the ministration of wonders is happening today. Jeremiah 32. It's in verse 17. Lord God, behold, thou hast made the heavens and the earth by thy great power and stretch out arm, and there is nothing to hide for thee.
Ewo onye wai Jehovah lejo wege emewele igwe n'uwa site n'ike uku gi na site na ogwu aka gi esetire eseti odi obula kariri gi me.
Nothing too hard for thee.
Odi obula kariri gi me.
Every prayer you pray here tonight.
Ebere obuna ki ike ebe n'ebe a n'abali
a. Bring a wonder into your life.
Oge weba tore ebube n'ime ndo gi.
Salvation.
Unsoputa.
It's coming.
Onabia.
Sanctification.
Odudo nso.
It's coming.
Onabia.
Power of the Holy Ghost.
Ike nke mmụọ nsọ.
It's coming.
Onabia.
Healing.
Ọgwụgwọ ọrịa.
It's coming.
Onabia.
Deliverance.
Napụta.
It's coming.
Onabia.
Prosperity.
Agamiru.
It's coming.
Onabia.
Ah, somebody needs a wife there. A good wife is coming on the way.
Ọdị otu onye chọrọ nwunye. Ezi nwanyị na-abịa n'ụzọ gị.
My lady, I've been praying. They come, they go, they come, they never stay. I am 41, 42. I'm not married yet. Good news coming your way. A good husband is coming in Jesus' name.
Ana me bebo owemu abia ajumu onye ọsọ abia ajumu elugoma for 41 ense akuko na abia esidi esinwanyi na abia nso gi na Jesus.
Grandma died of cancer. Mama died of cancer. And now it is my turn. I feel something here. Cancer has come. Good news for you. I said good news for you. What killed them and them and them, tonight I take that out of your life in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
The prayer was the ministration of wonders. Number 3. I told you 1, 2, 3. It's all over. Preparation for the manifestation of wonders. Preparation for the manifestation of wonders. Job chapter 11.
Job is
in Job chapter 11.
Now Job is in.
I'm reading from verse 13. You are getting ready. You are getting ready. Look up here. If you stay here, and somebody from there is walking towards you, if you stay there, eventually, if you don't leave that place, that person coming won't get to you. But if that person is coming, while the person is coming, you're also going towards him. You're coming, I'm coming. You'll get it faster. I said you'll get it faster. It's coming. You are coming. You get together at the middle point there. Miracle is coming. And you are coming. Get to you right there. Christ the wonder worker.
Jesus
is coming. And you are also coming to him. You are getting it right now. Your Savior is coming. You say, Savior, you are coming to me. I am coming to you too. It will happen. Your healer is coming. My healer, you are coming to me. I am sick. I am coming to you too. You get it very quickly. You are depressed. You're oppressed and you're afflicted, and your liberator, your redeemer, and the one that sets you free, he is coming, and you are coming. You are going to get it right now.
That's
a preparation. Christ is coming to you. You are coming to Christ. Salvation is coming to you. You are coming to the Savior. Deliverer is coming to you. You are coming to the Deliverer. And the Liberator is coming to you. And you say, I forsake everything of the past. Lord, I come. Lord, I come. You get it right now in Jesus' name. Job 11 verse 13. If thou prepare thine heart and stretch out thy hands toward him. If a child wants to be carried, the child will stretch out the hand to the one who wants to carry him. If you fold your hand and turn the other direction, how do you want him to carry you? You stretch out your hand. I surrender all. All to Jesus, my blessed Savior, I surrender all. You stretch out your hand. I'm not holding to anything anymore. I release my hand. I release my life. I release my personality, and I come to Jesus right now. You stretch your hand toward him. You surrender your life unto him. I know you can save any sinner. Lord, I come, save me. I know you can heal any sickness. Lord, I come, heal me. I know you can deliver any captive. Lord, I come, deliver me. Even if the devil binds me up with 1,000 chains, 1,000 cords, I know that you can break all the 1,000 cords. Lord Jesus, I come.
It
is that giving yourself unto Christ, stretching your arms toward him, that brings the deliverance. You are the person I'm talking about. I said you are the person I'm talking about. And you are going to get that miracle right now in Jesus' name. If iniquity be in thine hand, do you understand that? He says, stretch out your hand. You have been holding on to iniquity. Did you hear of that monkey before? Monkey likes granite and banana. When you want to catch a monkey, so you can roast him up in fire, you put banana and granite inside a glass bottle. The mouth of that glass bottle is wide enough to take the hand going in. But once the monkey holds that granite and holds the banana, and then he holds it to pull out the hand, will be very difficult. So the monkey puts his hand inside the glass bottle. He holds the banana, and then he tries to bring it out. Not possible. He lifts it and brings the hand out, and then the hand comes out. But he says, this free banana, I will not let it go. And while he's trying to pull it out, not releasing it, the hunter comes and the hunter catches him. The devil, your adversary, the hunter, goes about seeking whom he may devour. And while you are putting your hand inside the glass bottle, and you will not leave the drug, you will not leave all those bad things, and you are not releasing, the hunter will get to you there. You'll be roasted in the fire of eternity.
Okay.
That's why it says release. Give it up. If iniquity be in thine hand, put it far away. Let not wickedness dwell in that tabernacle. What's a release? Manifestation of wonders will begin tonight. Have you gone back home? I said manifestation will begin tonight. For then thou shalt lift up thy face without spot, yea, thou shalt be steadfast and shall not fear. Because thou shalt forget thy mystery and remember it as waters that pass away.
Thine
age shall be clearer than the noonday. You will shine forth and shall be as the morning. That shall be secured. Because there is hope for you. Yea, thou shalt dig about thee, and thou shalt take thy rest in safety. The miracle has started now. He is coming. You also come. Wonders are coming. You also come. That's how you prepare. And you stretch out your hand towards him. And release every bad thing you have been holding on to. And miracle will come immediately. Anybody who is ready there? Are you ready? Tonight there shall be showers of wonders. Showers of wonders. The rain is about to fall. Get up and get ready. Rain of salvation. Get up and get ready. Rain of healing. Get up and get ready. Rain of deliverance, get up and get ready. And rain of joy from heaven, get up and get ready. Remember, enter in. Remember, experience. Remember, enjoy. Enter into the showers of wonders. That means to come in. Enter. Christ is calling you. And you say, yes, Lord, here am I. I stretch my hands towards him. I surrender my life unto him. I release every form of iniquity I've been holding on to. Forgiveness will come. Salvation will come. Liberty will come. Freedom will come. Now take that step. Take that step. Jesus is calling you. Your Savior is calling you. And if you're taking that step now, I enter. You're taking that step, I enter. You're taking that step, I enter. You raise up your hand. You say, yes, Lord, it's me. Yes, Lord, it's me. Yes, Lord, it's me. Salvation is coming. Keep up that hand. Don't fold this, stretch it out. I release. I surrender. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for everyone stretching their hands toward the Savior right now as a sign of surrender, as a sign of giving up, their sin, giving up their iniquity, giving up their transgression, and they come to the Savior. As the Savior comes to them, Lord, Let that forgiveness be theirs right now in Jesus' name. Let that salvation come to them right now in Jesus' name. Let there be the joy of salvation, the peace in salvation, and the victory through salvation. Confirm it in their lives, Lord. Thank you, because we know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
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 Showers of healing. Showers of deliverance. Showers of miracles. Showers of answers to your prayer. I am ready. Where are you? It's coming your way. Showers of wonders. Father, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We thank you tonight. We bless your name tonight. Lord, open the heavens. Bring the showers down. Wonders on everyone. Healing for everyone. Deliverance for everyone. The removal of mountains for everyone. Lord, let the showers pour down right now. That brain problem, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. Insanity, madness, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. Epilepsy, be healed in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Those blind eyes, wonder of sight, wonder of miracle. Let there be brightness and seeing out of those eyes now in Jesus' name. Deaf ears, begin to hear in Jesus' name.
Tongues,
speak out in Jesus' name. That asthma, I command you, be healed in Jesus' name. Goiter, fibroid, hunchback, elephantiasis, waterhead, melt away right now. Be healed in Jesus' name. That terrible excruciating pain in your body, any part of your body, I command you pain, I command you plague, I command you affliction, I command you sickness, come out in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Leprosy in your body right there, I command there be cleansing, there be healing, be free in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Cancer of any kind.
Oh yeah, cancer, no, just, yeah, bro.
Cancer in the breast.
Oh yeah, cancer, nah, again.
Cancer in the body.
Oh yeah, cancer, nah, again.
Cancer in the lungs.
Oh yeah, cancer, no,
cancer in your liver.
Oh yeah, cancer, can you make
cancer in your system.
Oh yeah, cancer, get in,
I command that cancer now in the name of the Lord, by the power of the Holy Ghost, be healed in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
The pain of arthritis in any joint of your body, I send it away from you right now. Be healed in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Paralysis, you cannot remain there. Stroke, you cannot remain there.
Oh, yeah, stroke.
I sent for the power of God into your body. The joints to receive strength. The muscles to receive strength. That shoulder to receive strength. Your nervous system to receive strength. This is your time. This is your time. Rise up and walk in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Every yoke in your life is destroyed. All those moving objects in the head, in the back, in the body, anywhere, that moving object, that demonic attack, affliction, oppression, I command you, come out in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
I break every yoke in every life. I destroy the works of the devil in your body, in your life right now. Your mountains are removed. Your sicknesses are healed. Your oppressions, attacks are taken away. Be healed in Jesus' name. Be free in Jesus' name. You are delivered in Jesus' name. Almighty God, we thank you. Showers of wonders everywhere. Showers of healing everywhere. Showers of miracle everywhere. It's pouring down. It's pouring down. You've got it. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
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 Now begin to do what you are not able to do before. If you are lame, rise up and begin to walk. Whatever your problem, Christ has taken it away. You have exchanged it. Now miracle. Demonstration. Jump out of that wheelchair. Jump out of that wheelchair. Just rise up and keep walking down. Rise up and keep walking down. Want to listen to some of the testimonies.
Onye oblega na tuyo ehe ka gborume nshi ga na onwu ga hu ni he map na ko yi roje ka hafo nyabu no rube aye ga abako this program aga na kwado obuba moto me maru na ndu ha mar ka inege ohule wana mwa woru picture wa gbara oso dara na Boston shemu mujide this picture na evudu kwao na akporu chi no nso na abani na onye pick recall bu nwai na shina na bu no na akpo no bu wrong number na onye obula na arya arya osho no na arya arya na onwe ngihe mere na oburu na obar na ko nyiro na onyiro na ha fulile na aga mge kon nya bu na ya erute o ga bu mgbe obule papa anyi papa mu choro okpere anyi ekpere na enwe go ni picture elu maka na picture na bo bu mji bere na onyi chi chi na ke na picture na bo wani na ebido na onyi wa na ya ki na ebido zara me ekpere na before you na finish this program na ma na ekwenchi na wana nwanyi wa boro ya lata na obodo anyi kem nya bu ne I'm another than a half five. Oh God, my papa, I'm just a good boy, but I never got in hell. Now I'm not a good boy, but I catch you now. I go and see you now, and I go and say, "No, she's not going to me. She's not telephone now, Diano. Now I'm not me now, Diano. Diano, Diano, I'm not even on my phone. Let's see, no, sir, let her go. Now,
Jesus, Anthony, Jesus, Amen." I want you to rejoice more. Amen.
Amen.
This is how you can see the picture of our junior sister with the baby that he showed us. The junior sister said he's coming to visit one of their relations here in Enugu. And then he left more than a week or two ago. As he left to come to Enugu, he couldn't get to Enugu, and yet he couldn't come back. And he's a worker in the government circle, and he couldn't go to work the following Monday, and they started looking for her. And they called him, phone, they say he switched off. After some days, they called a woman, picked the phone and said, "The phone belonged to me." And then confusion everywhere. They reported, they went to Abuja, they went everywhere, and she was nowhere to be found. So when she was coming to this program, she came with a picture that wherever, any kidnapper that is holding my sister, any evil hand, must release her. Wonderful. Wonderful. Our Father in the Lord prayed, and today, telephone rang, your sister is back.
Amen.
The Lord release her from the hands of evil people. No evil hand will keep you or your relation. We listen to another testimony.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Afambo obeta selena. Esimi ha kubola afawebia. Mama na dim bi na newi. Na umo hamu kwa newi south. Heba akaibi. Mwenu na nna ini mwenye wanyi. Na biyo uwele. Mahua dike mamu. Mamu na aja hu. Kengwe mpamu mwuka mamu na aja hu. So ne mo obwamu ne ebureji ulogo nka. Ebureji nka. Unwe iho kwa lilo ne liro potala nebo anu. Ojije mwobero bido ne kume na okoku. Ewe nuna no na nna ini moye wanyi na bi owere we gboro aje that is okwe kwazi doctor proof nurse na nie na chime mambo partial stroke mbia gboro mam gboro aje bi owere chineke we na puta mam na partial stroke. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Nke chineke rukwara mu wa na owo mu na ebe abu. Na orugebe 5 years me we ikiji anya wa we go Bible na go anya mira na agbam enwere mi ki gwa obere go dika ihe lile na asachi asachi we kusize we jirize glass na go Bible ye ka mbia zereba andi na ka chineke si we gbam me bu na ejere mu na enwere be njere church na umuhu po ka njere church. Mpasa neba wese na na ya jiri glass ya go Bible for 10 years. Mana Chineke anaputa na ya. Ya jiri zanya mu wa o jiri anya na go Bible. Make until I have a hope, where by Jenkins, where the table, where baby, and a mahiji glass, where go Bible. You can not go, and go two chapters, and go three, go from a major glass. Upon a chinek and after, and praise the Lord.
Put your hands together for Jesus.
Oh, Jesus.
She gave testimony number one for the mother. The mother suffered partial stroke, and eventually, during Owerri program, she carried the mother to Owerri, and after the GS prayer, the mother is well, no more stroke. For her, she has sight problem. She cannot read without her glass. Whenever she reads, water is coming out. But after the prayer of the man of God during this program, the eyes was cleared. She can now read her Bible without any eye glass and all that. Jam your hand together for Jesus. We listen to another sister now.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Stena Mara Chineke, aham bu Sister Benedict Ebe. Esim na Kanu region we bia. Abukwa m otu onye n'ime unu. Ihe na akpo Chineke bu otutu to bu ga. Na one chele onye di ka muwa. We si na ochichiri we kpoputa m, babata m ihe ya. Na aro 1990. Ana meke ni kwa Chineke na o mere ka m na ezinu na mburu nke Christ. Hallelujah. Isi ọgbụgbọ ama m bụ ihe Chineke mere m. Ihe na-aya m bụ ukwu mgbu. And the ukwu mgbu ahụ etega aka obido na arọ gara aga last year na-egbu m. So ukwu a, unu na-eme anya ọfụmụ na ma na m abụghị agadi nwaanyị, mana m na-eme dịka agadi nwaanyị n'ihi ukwu ahụ. Eriela m ọgwụ ọtụtụ ugboro, ọ naghị ana. So olu ka a na-ekpe ekpere nwe si Chineke. Na chọzi m ịdị na-ebini dịka agadi nwaanyị na m chọrọ na-ebine mbinie ka Ada Zion bine ka giant. So mgbe onye ozi anyị bụ nna anyị n'ime Chineke Pastor W.F. Umuyi na Chineke ji alụ ọrụ, o wee si ị mara ebe ihe ọbụla ji gị bido aka ebe ahụ. Amam ka mbido n'ukwu mgbe nye aka n'elu nnakọta weze tie. Wele ofu bido n'ukwu, wele ofu bido n'afọ. Nsi Chineke taa, ị ga-agwọ m. Achọọ m ịnwụ ọgwụ ọzọ. N'isi na ego m na-enweta gị abụ ịnwụ ọgwụ ma ije n'ụlọ ọgwụ. Hallelujah. So mgbe Chineke mere, mgbe ekpere na-aga, mgbe ị na-ekwe the last amen, m wee ti amen. Ihe ọ dị n'ukwu dịka abịa pupu m ibu alọ n'ukwu m. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Put your hand together for Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Now.
Nambu, ewe omi ki me motwa. Me motwa. Ncho ipi ni mne me Mopgodu na lalolola. Before me.
Amen. That's all right. We thank you.
Hallelujah.
She said she has waist pain since last year. Cannot stoop, cannot bend, and it has excruciating pain. After sitting down to get up, pains. After lying down to get up, pains. But she came here after her father and the Lord have ministered and prayed. The whole waist pain was taken away. We listen to another testimony.
So afọ m bụ Elizabeth Nwafọ. Site na amara Chineke abụ m onye a mụrụ ọzọ. Esi m ọgụ district wee bịa. Toonu Chineke. So ihe Chineke mere m bụ na mbụ ọdụkọ ihe dị ka ahụla mbọ. Typhoid bido nye m nsogbu. Na-enye m nsogbu nwa aga na-ejekwu ndị ojibia bekee ha na-enye m ọgụ. Na-enye m ọgụ m na-eli. Mụ ndị ikwu enye ọtụtụ mma mgbe m. So otu a ka a na-ekwu maka GS na abịa maka ọ dị ya na-eme m otu nzukọta m akwara m ma akwọ m nụla mbọ ma ọkpọ m ike ụkwara onwe nke ojighi abịa. So ka nna ukwu na-abịa m ngoli a titi me kra mam la ma bia ku te la ga ma agbara ka we la o ge zutem so wo le pe pere na se e bo bla le nyo hu sobu e bo bla e ha do mo ku mo tu ka da ka la do ma so mo bia bi kwa se pa pa mle e ka ma ka ngba la bia e so ku la la mo to pa ma yo ma ga bi ga ya la ta mi ho la ta m so na ko kam cho ni nyaku ba ma malam simba sam ma le yeta kam ma lo mo kwa la hu mi fa ri ne mgbe tineke agbọwo m sitaolu onye nke tineke tineke wee si wee gba
put your hand together for Jesus. Amen. She has cough, she has pains that have lasted for some time now, but when she came after prayer, your cough went and the pains disappeared.